Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. I will be using my Insta360 camera, and I will be mounting it to the back of my Ford Lightning. I haven't seen many videos on people mounting it to trucks, so I saw like one mounted on a Super Duty. So this one will be mounting on a Lightning. Most of the time they're always mounted on cars, and it's on a back glass, and it's usually horizontal or slanted, but since I have a vertical back glass, and I'd have to put a really long stick to elongate it past the tailgate to kind of get that third person Forza Horizon look. So I kind of mounted it on my tailgate, but I have the Insta360 One X2. Very nice, very clear. I chose it over the RS and the GoPro 360 camera. But yeah, I'll be mounting on my Ford Lightning. Let me take you around the tailgate and show you the rear end. So guys, I have my Insta360 mounts. It's a 3-foot extension, and I have two Delkin Gecko mounts. I did not like the Delkin the Triple Gecko mount because I think it had a ball joint on the end, and it had no like support to it. And so I read comments where if you didn't tighten the ball joint hard enough, or even if it was tight, it would still had the tendency to fall or lose its grip and kill the camera if it hit the ground. So I saw another guy online I think he had a Nissan Z. He had he took two mounts like this, similar to this, but I kind of came up with my own design. So I just took this Delkin mount and I attached a camera clamp to it, and then I took this Delco shallow mount, and I used it, and so far so good. I've been up to speeds, I think about 90. I haven't been a little fast. I need to try a little faster, but has not came off. It does, you can kind of see it shakes a little bit, and sorry, the tailgate's kind of dirty, but maybe the metal on the tailgate kind of flexes. That's my only worry. I really did not want to put it on the paint, but it looks really good when I put it on. So I'm gonna put the camera on. Threads right on. 1/4 inch 20. I've seen some people have it like this or like this. I like to keep mine like this, and I'll stretch it out. I don't like to have it at an angle. Kind of tighten it to about there. It kind of gets tight, and I kind of have to have it there. It's kind of loose if I have it that way. There it goes. But some people, they'll have it, if they have a hinge right here, they'll fold it up, but you have to keep it vertical, parallel with the selfie stick to hide the selfie stick once it's all the way up. But yeah, I really like this. Okay guys, this is the only thing I use. I don't use that Triple Gecko mount because I don't trust it, and I've read a lot of bad things about it. But this is a Gecko just extension mount. I think this actually comes with the Triple Gecko mount. It comes with this extension when I just ordered this by itself, this whole piece. 1/4 20 threads. I purchased a camera clamp, and I attach it to this to grip the 360 selfie stick. It has has 3/8 threads and 1/4 20 threads. Of course, I use the 1/4 20 to mount to that. I use a shallow, I think it says 180 degrees, but that's like obviously 90 degrees or a little bit more mount. So I use that one, attach a selfie stick to this one. Take this one, attach the clamp to that, and then I use this with the clamp to support that so it can be really stable and I don't have to worry about this falling. So yeah, that's it. I'll probably put the links in the description for this, and then I will show some videos of it running on the truck. So we shall see how it goes. Thank you. this video helps for people that want to use a 360 camera on a vehicle and don't really want to use that triple gecko mount. Did something a little different, so give a like, drop a like. Thank you guys.